What is up, guys? Eric here from Real Film Reviews, bringing you another movie review, this time for the new Millie Bobby Brown film, Godzilla, King of Monsters. Godzilla, King of Monsters is directed by Michael Dougherty, stars Kyle Chandler, Millie Bobby Brown, Ken Watanabe, and Thomas Middleditch. This is the sequel to the 2014 Aaron Taylor Johnson, Bryan Cranston Godzilla film. This film picks up exactly 5 years after that film, as if real time has passed. San Francisco and Las Vegas were destroyed in that first film, and we are now seeing that there are more and more of these titans that are on the planet, and when some of them start to wake up, specifically a giant lightning dragon, it begins to cause a lot of hectic issues for the world as they try to figure out what to do to stop them. Look, this is a giant CGI fest monsters fighting each other movie. So the effects are really cool. Like, this movie looks fantastic. And granted, I can't really give credit to the camera work because 90% of the shots that are really awesome in this movie were just created on a computer, but I can give credit to Michael Dougherty for the directing of it because it all looks really good, and the massive undertaking that it must have been to do this film is beyond me because the scope of this movie is absolutely massive. And he also doesn't get lost in just massive explosions and buildings falling down. He makes sure that we see what's happening in the action. Sure, there are a few sequences where maybe there's a little too much going on, but for the most part, it doesn't try to hide these giant monsters behind massive smoke screens and explosions and things like that. We see them full on fighting and shooting laser beams and all the other stuff that they do in this film at each other, and it's extremely visually pleasing. Alongside it is a really, really operatic, roaring score that I think helps that giant monster movie feeling even more. The movie is chock full of massive monster fights that are enjoyable. I wouldn't say that, I don't know if they beat the fight at the end of the first Godzilla back in 2014, but some of them in this film are really, really good, while others are maybe a little more lackluster. But overall, I do think that the film is extremely visually impressive, and the fight scenes are definitely very entertaining to watch. And then even though this movie is chock full of talented actors, I do have to say that I think they all did the best they could. I specifically liked Ken Watanabe. He's really the only big carryover character from the first film, but I did enjoy him in it. I think he was entertaining again. He really fits the role that he's in perfectly, and I think that he's the standout of everyone in the film. And then my two big issues with the film are, well, you know, I know that this is a giant monster movie. I'm not gonna overlook that and be like, it should have all these other things. It should have intense, deep, emotional performances. No, I know that it shouldn't. It's a big lizard man destroying cities, fighting other giant lightning dragons and fire pterodactyls. But it doesn't change the fact that this movie's story jumps all over the place. Like, there are tonal shifts like crazy. It tries to have some weird comedy at times that just really doesn't work. And overall, just doesn't feel like it knew what kind of movie it wanted to be, other than that it wanted to have giant monsters fighting each other, which it successfully did that, which I will give it credit for. But besides that, it really doesn't know if it's trying to be dark and gritty, if it's trying to be a little lighthearted because it knows that it's a little crazy, if it's trying to find some nice middle ground to be like a dark comedy maybe, where we're watching a dark, gritty story, but we're getting some lighthearted levity in there. It really doesn't feel like it understands what it wants to be tonally, and it really hurts this movie and makes it feel very choppy at times. And that is paired alongside what I think is the biggest issue with this film, and it is that this movie has about a billion fucking characters. There are literally like over 10 characters that we are supposed to know by sight and their importance to the story, which is insanity, because that hurts that choppy, bad, sort of jumping all over the place feeling again, because we don't care about any of these characters whatsoever. I don't know about anyone else, but I sure didn't, because I never was able to get attached to any of them, because there's 90 of them that I'm supposed to give a shit about. So I think if they would have trimmed down the character list a little bit, it would have helped with the suspense in some of the scenes a little more, and it also would have helped the film feel a lot less choppy, because I only would have maybe had to follow a handful of characters, because honestly, if you ask me, there's really only maybe 4 characters in the film that play a major role, and everyone else really could have been a lot more of a supporting role than they were, but instead it feels like almost equal screen time for all of these side characters, and no one really feels like the main character. I'm gonna give Godzilla, King of Monsters a C. I realize that grade might seem a little high, being as I just kind of trashed it right there at the end, but at the end of the day, this is just supposed to be a big, fun, popcorn monster movie, and it very much so is that. If you go into this just wanting an entertaining 2 hours of monsters fighting each other, you will get at least that, but you will not get any more than that. Well guys, as always, I'm Eric. If you enjoyed this video, please do like, subscribe, comment down below what you thought of Godzilla King of Monsters, share everything we do here on Real Film Reviews, and hope to see you guys later.